giving a little tryout for the Shiner S'more, seeing how it is. They've been doing pretty good on their different beers they're trying out.
Okay, so Shiner's been making some very unique beers, and this is the S'more one. I really don't have to pour it to bottle. Okay, I definitely get the concept of marshmallow and the smokiness.
Hey,
this is my girlfriend.
Hello.
But we'll give it a pour and see what it looks like. Nice and brown. The body's not too deep, not too heavy, but it has some depth to it. It has a slight sweetness, not too much. So it's basically a beer with the concept of s'mores to give you that campfire feel and taste with the linger of the marshmallow. It's a little bitter on the front, but other than that, I don't really get the graham cracker part, but I get more of the caramel, smoky, and marshmallowy. So that's where I'm at. But it's not super sugary or anything, so I can try it. I don't think I'll do it again, but it's not bad. Enjoy. All right, on the next part of the video, I don't have any fancy stuff yet. I'm still starting out, but I do ask that please subscribe and check this out. I'm not trying to be like a connoisseur that's snobby. I just want to help you decide if you want this beer, if you've seen it, if you heard of it, if you see it on the shelf. These videos are made to be quick, fast, so you can see about it and help make your choices or branch out into other things. There's a lot of people already doing it. Wonderful. I'm glad. Craft beers have definitely become a part of my life, but I've always been a beer guy. So just hit subscribe, hit a like, help me keep moving forward. Any beers that are in Austin that you can see or find, I will do my best to grab a hold of those ones first so that we can get them moving, because we keep them fresh, keep them drink up, and we can keep getting good beer over here. So right now, thank you for your support. I think anyone that has liked it and checked me out, and any little facts I try and do, I try to add to the videos.